Today on Internet Marketing Pro, we're going to discuss blogging advice for people who have no time to blog.
Are you legally minimizing your future tax burden and staying compliant in today's complex tax code? If not, our sponsor, Michelieu Consulting, has over 30 years' experience providing top-quality professional services in accounting and tax preparation for a wide variety of clients just like you. Whether you need tax return filing, planning, bookkeeping, financial statements, full-service payroll, or corporate or individual tax return filing, I personally recommend you to contact Jeffrey Ressler, CPA, at 561-237-5264. That number again is 561-237-5264. And you can visit the website at jrcpa.net. That is jrcpa.net. Tell Jeff that Chad Deckard sent you from this podcast to receive a special rate for listening to this show. Thank you very much. Broadcasting from the city of hot sun and rain off the Atlantic Ocean in Boca Raton, Florida. Good morning, good evening, wherever you may be across the nation and around the world. I'm your host, Chad Deckard, and welcome to my Internet Marketing Pro and eZineGenerator.com podcast show. Our shows will cover how to grow your business, as well as topics on tips, tricks, and techniques, digital lifestyles, the future of finance, entrepreneurism, and preeminent professional Internet marketers. Thank you for tuning into our show as we begin this adventure together, exploring many great things to come. Now, let's cover a quick few announcements before we get started. And like I always begin my shows, I really like to show my personal appreciation for all the feedback that we have been getting from you all. What a difference it makes in motivating me to put these shows out and continually think of the next subject matter that we can explore together. We are also very excited about helping us get more subscribers, and why not subscribe yourself and also share this content with your social networks. Finally, be sure to review our past archive shows on iTunes, Stitcher Smart Radio, YouTube, and Zoom. Now, let's get down to business.
The social media world falls victim to an environment of haves and have-nots. There are those people that are very socially connected. They're on Twitter, Facebook, and they blog a ton. And then there are those others that look at the socially connected in either awe, like, wow, how do I get to be like you? Or derision, where who has time to do all this stuff? I believe the problem for the social media have-nots is that they haven't figured out how to ingrain social media into their daily lives. Because the most common complaint that I hear from this audience is either what do I talk about or I have no time to blog. If you feel either way, let me reassure you that you do have plenty of time to talk about and you do actually have time to blog. The problem is you haven't figured out how to register these moments. You know, finding stories to blog about and recording them effectively requires constant active thinking. Get good enough at it and it becomes second nature. You see, good stories and opportunities and headlines jump out at you. And the formation of the story immediately starts to gel, allowing you to quickly write and record the story. There's a parallel in martial arts, where extremely well-trained fighters simply can't be surprised. They're always at the ready, and they're always in defense mode for themselves. To find stories, write about, and the time to blog means to know when the story appears and how it needs to be discussed or digest for your audience. It's the job of the reporter or the editor and everyone else that can exercise these same mental muscles in our daily lives. How to find time to blog? Well, let's ask this question. What do you want to be known for? Often the reason people don't start blogging is they don't know what they want to blog about. The answer to that question can be found when you answer the simple end result question, what do you want to be known for? Once you know that, you'll be able to form the editorial voice of your blog. Now, here are some points that I want to point out to you for people who don't think they have time to blog is think in headlines. What ideas and opinions do you have? You'll want to formulate them as headlines. Look at the type of headlines that catch your eye and how the same structures could be used to be the framework for what you want to talk about. Popular headline structures include numbered lists, how-tos, best practices, and what not to do. And how can your stories be formed in these headline structures? The next point I'd like to make in question is, what do you keep repeating? We all find ourselves repeating the same personal anecdotes or explanations of our business, in person or over email. Every time you find yourself in one of those, I'm repeating one of those stories again, write a quick note to yourself. That story will be your next blog post. And the next time someone asks you that same question, instead of repeating yourself, just send them to the link to that post. Let the post and the blog work for you. Next point that I'd like to make is look at your sent email. Go through the past couple weeks of sent emails and see if you have, you know, one of those I'm repeating myself moments, or maybe you just wrote a long email to someone, and take a look at the message. Would it make a good blog post if you did a little editing? If so, do it. Next point, blog about a great conversation. Conferences, trade shows, and dinners are where you'll engage in great conversation. Make a note of the conversation and immediately write something about it when you get home, when it's still fresh in your mind. Another point would be tell personal stories. My most popular, you know, podcasts are actually based on real stories that happened to me or other people, and people can relate to those stories. Also, if the story happened to me, I can pretty much guarantee that no one else wrote about it, so it's unique to myself. And it's usually been my perspective, and it's interesting to see what other people have to say about my perspective. Either they share it or they don't. Can't make everybody happy. Another point to make that I'd like to make is keep what to blog about file. So you want to keep a file that keeps your, you know, ideas in, and ideas will pop into your head all the time. When you're out and about talking to people or browsing online, you may not have the time to write the entire post at a given moment, but you will have time to make a note about it. Keep a file of just headlines on your computer and another one in the notes section of your mobile device. And my last point that I'd like to make is that you can videotape moments and interview people that you meet. If you've got an iPhone, a flip camera, or a similar device, or a recording device like me, an H4N, a digital recorder, you've got an easy-to-carry device that can go anywhere with you. But just because that you have the tools to record video or audio doesn't mean that you're going to use them. Most people don't ask for interviews or record in the moment events because of a fear of looking awkward or a fear of how to approach a person for an interview. If that's you, recognize it and just start doing it. Start by interviewing a friend first before you interview a stranger. For more on tips on, you know, how to record or interview people, you know, please refer to my site or refer to a, search for an article written by Sharon Vaknin, and her name is Sharon. Her last name is Vaknin, and she wrote on Socialbrite, and her article is entitled Create Video Stories for Your Nonprofit in Six Steps. And, you know, you could take it, even though you might not be a nonprofit, you could still utilize those steps in any application. So it's not just limited to nonprofit. It's just that she was, you know, focusing on nonprofit. But always be on alert for stories, because the reason people don't think they have time to blog is because they're not consciously always looking for blog post opportunities. Successful blogging that doesn't eat up your time requires you to consciously think about all these things and know when to capitalize on them. You've already made the time for the stories by telling them in emails and conversations. All you have to do is transfer the existing storyline to some type of publishing platform to begin blogging on any platform, whether it's WordPress, Joomla, or any other platform that you might be used to manage your blog. So, I appreciate you for tuning in for this show, and you have a great week, and we'll be back next week. Thank you. Bye-bye.